All right, folks, it's Tuesday now. We're back at the J6 Flips mothership. Only have one thing that sold today. It wasn't even on eBay. It was on Instagram. I posted that jersey we bought yesterday at the bins, and someone, a Liverpool fan, spotted it. Shout out Jason from Straight Gaming and Stuff. Appreciate you reaching out. I gave him a good deal, and he was stoked with the price. So we're going to go ahead and get this jersey here shipped out. Got the Liverpool thing there, and, of course, the tags. So let's go. Back at the Goodwill bins. It's Tuesday. Last time I was a little bit slower. This time it looks about the same as yesterday, so should be some competition in there, but plenty for everyone.
Diving right in here, we find these Wrangler jeans. These are beige. I've found and sold blue ones before. A nice bread and butter sale at the bins. I mean, at the prices here, definitely worth picking up. And I was looking for the size tag. If you're ever looking for the size tag, they're on the inside of the zipper, just like this. So there's a J6 Flips tip for you. Then I came across a new-to-me brand, Xanarobe. I'm not even sure if I'm pronouncing that right, but at the prices here, I was willing to take the risk on this t-shirt. Another new-to-me brand. Luckily, we have our resources to research these things, and I saw some crazy prices on other platforms, so I was definitely willing to take this home and see if it was worth much. I didn't know where to price it. Here's my listing. And peeking through this pile here was this GoRuck weight carrier. It's for weight training. I knew it was worth money, and this was new with tags, so it's already sold. I love picking up jerseys of all kinds. I hadn't seen anything like this before, but the comps were there, so I went ahead and picked up this Overwatch League jersey. I always come across Boy Scouts of America gear here at the bins, and I always pick it up because it does sell. It's not for a lot, but this one came with a lot of attachments to it. It had a couple of scarves, it had a couple things dangling off of it, and it even had this metal piece, so we'll see what we can get for it. It is the bins, so you definitely have to take your time to thoroughly look through everything. Usually it pays off, though. I came across this hoodie here. It's a Harry Potter hoodie, similar to ones I've sold before from Universal Studios. I didn't notice it at the moment, but this one's actually new with tags. If you see the armpit there, there's a tag dangling. Another jersey I'd never seen before, but it was definitely a Mexican Baseball League jersey because of the logo on the back, and I've actually already sold this one, but we'll talk about that in a second. I do end up buying this Nike Yoga long sleeve. It's like a thermal drop cut shirt. What I don't notice in the bin's lighting is that there's a stain on this sleeve here. I just priced it lower and hopefully it sells. Every trip to the bins isn't complete without some nursing scrubs. They're always there, and a good brand to look out for is Figs. They always sell, and at these prices, you gotta pick these up.
All right, so we spent another $25. This GoRuck thing is awesome. And a lot of nice clothes, so nothing too crazy this time. But some nice bread and butter in there for $25.
Alrighty, my people, now it is Wednesday. We're heading to the storage unit. We have 6 items to ship out, and it's about 20 minutes until the Salvation Army opens. So we're gonna try to rush to get through these and get to the Salvation to hopefully not lose out on everything. Don't think we'll be there right when they open, but we'll be there early enough. So, and then we'll hit a couple more thrift stores. Since we hit the bins the last 2 days, we wanted to make sure we're not forgetting about the thrift stores, but at least checking in and seeing what's up.
So. Okay, folks, so I've grabbed everything that's sold. This first thing is some filament for a 3D printer. Grabbed a couple of these in Bakersfield, and this one sold. Not a lot of profits on them, but some profits, so I'll take it. This is something that sold on Instagram, actually. Someone saw I bought it at the bins and was willing to pick it up from me. Give them a good deal, obviously, because they're just a follower and they support the channel. But it's a Mexican baseball jersey from Jalisco. I forget what the mascot is, but there's a thing on the sleeve there. This thing I've had for a long time. It's a Nordic Ware egg waffle maker thing, made in USA. Not sure why I picked it up. I paid a little too much for it, but still ended up getting profit, so I'm happy about that. Lucky Brand jeans, recently picked these up. These are 42-32. Big reason I bought them was because they're a larger size, and they sold within a week. This is a Ruka button-up shirt, or not button-up, but a sports shirt, new with tags. Unfortunately, it was too big for me, so I just put it on eBay and it sold. So with the money I got from selling this gift I got, I'm going to buy myself a Ruka shirt. And second to last thing are these office characters. This is Oscar from The Office, and most of them are in here. There's Christmas, Michael Scott. And then the last one's out here from my first video ever, a pool. Literally been sitting in the corner of my storage unit. I'm kind of nervous to see what it's gonna cost to actually ship this because it is heavy. And I'm honestly not even sure how I'm gonna ship it. Like, do I just slap a label on this thing, or do I put it in a box? is that redundant to double box something? But we'll figure it out.
All right, folks, so I finished packaging everything, and also I canceled the pool order. I didn't realize it was supposed to go to Puerto Rico. Because of the way I put the shipping information, I think I only put it at 10 pounds, and the dimensions were all off because it was one of my earlier listings from my early flipping days. And unfortunately, it was just gonna cost way too much to send a pool that's 26 pounds to Puerto Rico. So I ended up canceling. I sent them a message saying, hey, apologies for the cancellation, but it's gonna cost me $2 more than you paid entirely to just ship it. So I don't know if they're gonna care about that or how much it's gonna ding my account, but this is just one of those times where I wasn't willing to bite the bullet to ship something for 80 bucks. So lesson learned, obviously. Again, I feel like I've did this before with another item, but it's just a nice reminder to always just be on it. The listings are important, the information on there. I think I estimated 10 pounds, which is way off. It was almost triple that. So again, it was one of my earlier listings, so I don't feel so bad about it. But now I know I probably should go through my oldest listings and make sure all the dimensions are right. Either way, it's been done. What would you guys have done though? Would you have just shipped it and bit the bullet for it? Or would you do the same as I did and cancel that thing? Let me know. All right, so we're not gonna mope around about losing that sale in the pool. We're gonna go to Salvation and find some more stuff. Here's a Chelsea jersey. This thing's falling apart though. It looks legit. It's got a weird grease stain. The letters are falling off there. The logo's fine. Not that. Ooh, the number's completely gone. Future. With the wrapper. Polo G. Oh, this is cool. Thrasher magazine. Soccer jersey. The trademark 666 on the middle there. Oh, this is a come up. So this is a cool Italy jacket. It's got a stain there, but that looks like I can clean it. The letters in the back are a little suspect, but sleeves are good. Buttons are fine. So I might have to pick this up and see how clean I can get it. I will look up comps to see if any of these sell, but these look pretty superficial. I think I can get them out. So just quickly looking over the comps, it doesn't seem like it'll be worth it. This one's 30 free shipping. That's if I can get it cleaned up. And their jackets or coats are 13 bucks. Unless this is considered a long sleeve, which would be 7 bucks. Actually, that looks pretty bad. We're just gonna leave it. Seems like more of a hassle than it is a flip. Here's an item I've picked up before and sold before. This one doesn't look as good a condition as the ones I did sell. This one's a little more faded. And then this one's another Orbis. But the blue looks even also faded. The material just looks a little washed out. So I'm just gonna leave those. Now this looks like more something I would pick up. It's a Browning hunting hoodie. The embroidery looks fine there. It is a bigger size, a large, so it should be fine. Got the camo on the inside. No tears or stains. It's just a quick wash and list, so I'm gonna grab this. Okay, here's another one. I've never seen a light blue one before. And this one seems to be in much better condition, size medium. I'm willing to pick this one up. That's what I mean by being picky though. Sometimes you pick them up, other times you leave them.
You can see me inspecting these shorts pretty thoroughly. There's a lot of cycling gear at the thrift stores, but not all of it's really valuable. But this one just had that feeling like it was.
This is like an Italian brand of cycling. These pads are for cyclists. I'm gonna have to grab these. They look expensive. Haven't been here 1 week and they changed it up on me. They put all the linens and pillows against the what used to be electronics wall, and they made this more home goods that also used to be more electronics. So that just shows if you're not here often, things will change up on you. So this is an interesting thing, but there's no price tag on it either, so I'm not sure what they're hoping to get out of this. Honestly, might be on the bottom. Nope. The wheel is busted though, so I'm gonna leave this. So this is a big maybe. It's got working things, so that's always nice. It is older, it is a little dusty, but it's not too bad. It's $25, but I do have a coupon. Alright, I think I have to take this. Okay, so I ended up spending $14 in there on 4 items. I ended up leaving the Nike golf bag because I didn't notice a part on the bottom was cracked. It didn't look like it affected it too much, like it still functioned, but I didn't want to have to store it and hold on to it, waiting for someone who didn't mind the broken part, so I just left it. Sometimes it's better to leave things than to hope for that perfect buyer to come along. Don't have time to get to the further thrift stores yet, so I'm gonna just hit this local Goodwill and had a couple random miscellaneous things to drop off to donate, so come in here and... All right, we didn't find much of anything in there. A lot of overpriced things and things that would flip, but not for that price. So as usual, Goodwill is overpriced and we can't find anything, but that's all right. Just keep looking. All righty, folks, it's Thursday, which means we're hitting the Hope of the Valley. Somehow, some way, we've kind of made ourselves a little routine of Mondays and Tuesdays being at the bins and Wednesdays and Thursdays. Wednesdays mostly just kind of hitting the other shops on the west side of where I'm at. And then Thursday, going out to Hope of the Valley and the Salvation Army on the other end where I'm at. So it kind of works out that way. Obviously, being at the bins every day would probably be best, but I can't be there 24/7. It's just overwhelming in there, and I don't want to be in that dusty environment all the time either. But I also want to keep tabs on my local thrift stores. There are some good deals in there. They do not always overprice things, and they'll miss everything. So you really just have to stay on it to catch them. But as long as we're kind of keeping tabs on the local thrift stores and also going to the bins to always keep inventory coming in, we should be good on things to flip. So right now we're going to go see if we can find some 25% off goods and then hit the Salvation Army that's on this side. So let's do it. All right, so no hard goods. Still got the empty cart here. But I'm making my way back to the front. I saw a good deal, I think. Might be able to make a couple lots. Not finding a lot. Everything seems to be pretty overpriced. Looks cool, but I don't know if anyone knows Niagara. Keaton. No year on this. This is cool. $11. People like Oregon. Okay, so there's a Bombas socks, 99 cents each. There's a couple in each bin, maybe like 30 of them. It says not for resale, but a lot of them are on eBay selling, so if not, I got a lot of running buddies who might make use of them, so I might just grab them all. All right, so the bins are clean. We've got a full basket of Bombas.
Felt like the music just kept getting louder and louder while I was here, but I ended up finding this Eileen Fisher wool jacket. It's a full zip, 90s looking thing, so I picked it up. Then I came across this very cool Kansas State Nike jacket. It's like a waterproof one that a football player would wear on the sideline, and the fact that it's a 2XL is very likely that a player did once own this, but they donated it, so I was definitely going to grab this. I think they had it priced at $12. Wasn't going to leave this behind, especially thinking it can get at least maybe $40-$50. And it looks super warm on the inside, so it likely won't sell till the fall, but that's okay, it should sell. And then there was this hoodie right next to it that was curiously priced, only a dollar less. I'm not sure why they would do that, but I definitely had to check the comps to see if it was really worth picking this thing up.
Kind of surprised by the comps here. Unfortunately, they don't really sell for much. This one, 3XL, it sold for $30 plus shipping. This one's a team issued one with a number. We don't have that. But this one sold for $5, $20, $20, $20. Took an offer on $50, $25. I don't think so. I'd rather just get this one if I had to pick one.
Another J6 Flips tip here for you. It's actually a pretty common knowledge thing, but uniforms for businesses usually sell pretty well. I had an AT&T shirt that just sold, and this is a T-Mobile one that would have made some more money, but I only pick these up at the bins. I don't worry about paying thrift store prices for things like this.
I was just thinking of a great tip from the Third Eye Liquidator guys. Trevdo Baggins once said, if you can get a good deal on a bunch of stuff, buy them all. Don't leave any behind. Like, don't take 12 and make money on 12. Take them all, because if you leave some behind, someone else is going to come and get them as well. And you just made yourself direct competition, so always take them all. Okay, so we ended up getting 74 pairs of socks. And then this on the side. So we ended up paying 78 obviously for 74 socks and then it closed, so that works out very well.
Salvation Army. This thing looks cool. Apparently it's like a dental tool or something. Not sure exactly what it does. New and complete with all the little pieces. It sells for like 100 and something new. But someone sold one for 20. So these guys must be on eBay looking for prices on something like this. This is a Sears Robeck & Co. cassette player. This one sold for 30 bucks. But this one sold for two. They want 25. Not happening. So this is just a logo I learned of when I grabbed some shorts. And this actually has a tag, so there it is, Giordano. You could tear it at the seam, luckily they didn't. Made in Italy, it's a cycling hat. So you get to wear the front there, and this looks like it covers your ears and your neck maybe, so hats are $4 here.
And one last find here, a Tory Richard Hawaiian shirt. I usually don't pick these up unless they're larger or a cool design, and this one was definitely cool with the dragons. And of course, it's already sold.
All right, so we just got this Tory Richard shirt and the Giordano hat. Nothing too crazy, but again, just trying to get a couple things and keeping tabs on the stores. Okay, so there we have it. A couple sales there, a couple pickups there from the Salvation Army. Nice find at the Hope of the Valley. Only a find really that you can get from keeping tabs on the place. Most people kind of overlook that corner or don't even notice the bin is there. But obviously I noticed the difference just from being there frequently, and then I noticed that they were there and came up on the sale, so, or on the deal, so. And then the bins earlier in the week got my inventory up, so it's just nice to have a nice balance of that. Not only just keeping up on my local stores, but also being able to keep a nice flow of inventory coming and keep me busy. Something to list, something to take photos of, and obviously with this footage, something to edit. And I should probably get on that video editing. I'm just going to hit the storage now, send out my sold items, but I'm going to leave you here. Appreciate y'all watching. Thank you again and take care.